I know. It's been a couple weeks. Listen, you'll understand in time. But at the end of the day, you have to understand this. The Lord will raise up a deliverer. You know what time it is. Let's get it.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
Accepting the fact that my goal is the top, then knowing heaven is in that spot, keeps driving me nonstop. Never allowing hell to defeat me. It's not possible as long as it's beneath me. Nothing sent from there could ever reach me.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is Apostle Makhario coming to you all again. And I know for some of you, you're like, Apostle, it's been a couple weeks. Where you been? Listen, one thing I tell you all and I teach you all the time is that never allow yourself to get too attached to anything. Let the Spirit of the Lord lead you. I'm not going to get so attached to YouTube and teaching people on YouTube that I will not get rest or that I miss God if he wants to do something different. But, you know, the Lord is always talking to me. He's been talking to me, and I'm actually having to go back in the Rolodex, back in the index, back in what the Spirit of the Lord has been speaking to me all over these past 2.5 weeks-ish that I haven't uploaded a video, I guess it was. But I'm going back, and I actually have to go back before that, but for now I'm just going to go back to this. The Lord will raise up a deliverer. One thing you all have to understand is when people do not want to follow the ways of the Lord, and they go off doing their own thing, or a generation dies off that did not teach the next generation about the things of God, and so the following generation go out and they become worse than their parents, or they forget the Lord quicker, or they don't know anything about God. The Lord will raise up a deliverer when they turn back to him. So let's get into this really quickly. The Lord will raise up a deliverer. This is for you. He gave me this message before I took this break. But when I took this break, I was at Cedar Point and different things. Insert said clip here.
What's going on, YouTube? With the family at Cedar Point. If you all, Cedar Point. Of course, I gotta get a little video footage to let you guys know. It's always good to have fun. Every once in a while, you need to, you know, get a break.
Yeah, so that was just a quick clip of me at Cedar Point. So, the Lord will raise up a deliverer. Let's get into this. Judges chapter 2, starting at verse 6. And when Joshua had let the people go, the children of Israel went every man unto his inheritance to possess the land. And the people served the Lord all the days of Joshua and all the days of the elders that outlived Joshua, who had seen all the great works of the Lord that he did for Israel. And Joshua the son of Nun, the servant of the Lord, died, being 110 years old. Nice long life, right? And they buried him in the border of the his inheritance in Timnathheres, in the Mount of Ephraim, on the north side of Gash. And also all that generation were gathered unto their fathers, and there arose another generation after them, which knew not the Lord, nor yet the works which he had done for Israel. That is the problem. When there's a generation that comes up, and they come up in a quote-unquote Christian household, and they don't know the Lord. I always tell you all, teach people what you know, not what you think. I always tell preachers, don't teach what you think, teach what you know. What you know by the word of God, what you know in prayer, what you know through fasting, studying, and praying. It says there arose a generation which knew not the Lord, nor yet the works which he had done for Israel. And this is what happens when they don't know the Lord or the works that he did. And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord and served Balaam, a false god, which is what people are doing now with yoga and Mahatma Gandhi and following all these people and getting into this LSD opioids because they want a spiritual experience, but their fathers before them and their mothers before them did not teach them the ways of the Lord. So the spiritual experience that they're looking for are not the things of God. And so they're looking for a spiritual experience, an experience to let them know that there's something greater than self, and they turn to drugs and other things and it doesn't work out. It only makes it worse for them. Because the people that knew the Lord The generation that came up before them should have been teaching their children about God, and they chose not to do so. But this is a problem. So it says here, verse 12 of Judges chapter 2, "And they forsook the Lord God of their fathers, which brought them out of the land of Egypt, and followed other gods," with an S, "of the gods of the people that were round about them," pay attention to that, "and bowed themselves unto them, and provoked the Lord to anger. And they forsook the Lord and served Baal and Asheroth. And the anger of the Lord was hot against Israel, and he delivered them into the hands of the spoilers and that spoiled them, and he sold them into the hands of their enemies round about, so that they could not any longer stand before their enemies." How many people do you know in the church that that's happening to, that say that they serve God but are not serving God, or turned away from the Lord, and they have to bow themselves down to a bunch of evil, and they're serving false gods? They've left the church. They started off praise team leaders or worshipers, or they started off ministers or pastors in the church, or some of them started off false in even being a minister or a pastor in the church, and they've walked away from God, or they've misled a bunch of God's people, they've started a cult, or they just left the Lord completely to serve their own ways and their own gods. And it says in verse 15 of Judges chapter 2, "Whithersoever they went out, the hand of the Lord was against them for evil, as the Lord had sworn, as the Lord had said, and as the Lord had sworn unto them, and they were greatly distressed." Here's one of the key factors, though. The Lord is trying to work in your favor, and even when you turn away, he's trying to work for your benefit to bring you back to him, that you do not end up the way the rest of the sinners will end up. Judges chapter 2, verse 16, it says, "Nevertheless, the Lord raised up judges, which delivered them out of the hand of those that spoiled them. And yet they would not hearken unto their judges," this happens a lot, "but they went a whoring after other gods and bowed themselves unto them. They turned quickly out of the way which their fathers walked in, obeying the commandments of the Lord, but they did not so. And when the Lord raised them up judges, then the Lord was with the judge, and delivered them out of the hand of their enemies all the days of the judge. For it repented the Lord because of their groanings by reason of them which oppressed them and vexed them. And it came to pass when the judge was dead, that they returned and corrupted themselves more than their fathers in following other gods to serve them and to bow down unto them. They ceased not from their own doings, nor from their stubborn ways. And the anger of the Lord was hot against Israel, and he said, because that this people hath transgressed my covenant, which I commanded their fathers, and have not hearkened unto my voice, I also will not henceforth drive out any from before them of the nations which Joshua left when he died, that through them I may prove Israel whether they will keep the way of the Lord to walk therein, as their fathers did it, or not. Therefore the Lord left those nations without driving them out hastily, neither delivered he them into the hand of Joshua." So once again, the Lord will raise up judges. The Lord will raise up a deliverer. But when the Lord raises up a deliverer, you all, I'll say it, thank you, Jesus. Okay, Holy Ghost, you're with me. You all are so stubborn and rebellious that when the Lord raises up a deliverer, you choose not to listen to the deliverer. When the Lord raises up a judge, you choose to believe the way of the world and say, "I feel like you're judging me." Yes, we're judging you because the Lord raises up judges. The Lord raises up a deliverer. The judge is a deliverer for you. If you do the right things, you don't have to worry about it. But when you do the wrong things, you need to be in fear. Because it says that the hand of the Lord was hot against them, that the Lord didn't drive out your enemies from before you, because you decided not to walk in his way. Let's continue on. Judges chapter 3. Verse 9, because I want you all to get this. The Lord raised up multiple judges to help the children of Israel to get out of the oppression. Some of them would listen. Many of them obviously did not and continued to serve false gods. Judges chapter 3, verse 9. When the children of Israel cried unto the Lord raised up a deliverer to the children of Israel, who delivered them, even Othniel, the son of Kenaz, Caleb's younger brother. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon him, and he judged Israel, and went out to war, and the Lord delivered Shushanithrim, king of Mesopotamia, into his hand, and his hand prevailed against Shushanithrim, and the land had rest 40 years, and Othniel, the son of Kenaz, died. Once again, when you listen to the deliverer, when you listen to the judges that God raises up, you shall have rest. But when you choose to be stubborn and do your own thing, I feel the Holy Spirit, you will not have rest in the spirit. You will not have rest in the natural. You will not have rest in your body. The Lord raises up people, apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, those that know his spirit and live for him, to be a judge and a deliverer for you. Yes, we have to judge the things that you do according to the word of God. That's what we're supposed to do. That's what we're called to do. But also, if you listen to the judgments that we give, we'll give it with the end of it being the love of God. Yes, it's going to seem harsh, but hopefully it's to bring you to correction or to bring you back into alignment with the things of God. A true man or woman of God will never judge you just to see you hurt. They'll expose or bring it into judgment to see you come back to the Lord wholeheartedly. That way you can have rest. That's what it says here in Judges chapter 3, verse 11. And the land had rest 40 years, and Othniel, the son of Kenaz, died. So as long as the judge was alive, or the deliverer, the land had rest. When the judge or the deliverer died, the people had no rest because they went back whoring after their gods. You say, well, that's just one. Let's continue in Judges chapter 3. It says in verse 15, but when the children of Israel cried, which means they went back to doing their own thing, Judges chapter 3, verse 15, but when the children of Israel cried unto the Lord raised up a deliverer, Ehud, the son of Jerah, a Benjamite, a man left-handed, and by him the children of Israel sent a present unto Eglon, the king of Moab. And then it goes into what happened and how Ehud delivered the children of Israel out of their oppression. And then it says here in Judges chapter 3, verse 30, and you can read through chapters 2 and 3 on your own. But it says here in Judges chapter 3, verse 30, so Moab was subdued that day under the hand of Israel, and the land had rest 40 years. This time it wasn't just 40 years. This time it was 80 years that they had rest because of the judge and the deliverer that the Lord raised up for the children of Israel because they cried unto the Lord. And as long as the deliverer was alive, the Bible said, they served God. But when the judge died, they went back whoring after their own gods. It's sad to say that people do those things, because you can see the manifestation of God's glory through a person, and God used someone to help you get set free. And yet, if that person's not around, if that person, God leaves them somewhere else for a little while, many of you go back to your own old, disgusting, despicable, ungodly ways. You go back to serving false gods because you haven't trained yourself to hear the voice of the Lord also. It's great because God sends teachers for you to listen to. God sends people like me and other apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers who can manifest his glory, or just another saint that believes the word of God wholeheartedly, that's living right. He sends them to help you come to another level. Another level in him, another level of faith, another place in God if you listen. If you don't, the hand of the Lord is against you. God didn't change his ways. And that's why I tell people the Old Testament and New Testament are not books that are separate, that should be completely apart from one another. They tie in all of the Bible. I teach you all this all the time. God gives us the same things over and over again because repetition is the father of learning, and it comes from the Father, God, the true and living God, the only true God. And so you all may say, well, I'm fine, because I hear older people say that because they think they're okay with God, and God is like, no, you've been stuck in this rut for 40 years, and some of them, their situations have gotten worse because they try to listen to themselves. They go whoring after other gods, and they think that they're fine with God, and they listen to themselves, and every year it gets worse. And I sit back and I watch it, and I'm like, Lord, why can't they see? Why can't they see? But the thing is, they dance around knowing God. They don't really want to know him, because when God starts to deal with the parts of their heart, or the parts that's in their minds, or the part that's in their soul that they don't want anybody to touch, they treat God like God is another person. That's why they call God daddy and not father. God is a father. He's not a daddy. Okay? So because they don't want anybody to touch it, they don't even want God to touch it. When God tries to deal with it, they get upset. They get offended. They get scared. They walk away. They turn away. And God is like, I'm trying to deliver you from this and bring you into a place of rest. But because you choose not to listen, I can't do that. Let's go into the New Testament really quickly. And I wasn't going to go here, but the Spirit of the Lord is leading me here, so I'm going to go here. Let's go into Romans chapter 13, because I want you all to get it. You have to be judged. And when you're judged, as the Bible says, you are chastened of the Lord that you should not be condemned with the world. I'll show you that verse in a moment. Romans chapter 13, it says this here. Start at verse 1. Let every soul be subject unto higher powers, for there is no power but of God. The powers that be are ordained of God. Whosoever therefore resisteth the power, resisteth the ordinance of God. And they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. So you're choosing to resist, and the Bible says you're going to receive to yourself damnation. For rulers are not a terror to good works, but to the evil. Wilt thou then not be afraid of the power? Do that which is good, and thou shalt have praise of the same. For he is a minister of God to thee for good. But if thou do that which is evil, be afraid, for he beareth not the sword in vain, for he is a minister of God, a revenger, to execute wrath upon them that do evil. The Lord says we don't bear the sword in vain. If you're talking bad about us, backbiting, whatever it may be, spreading lies, spreading rumors, God says we don't bear the sword in vain. And once again, the Bible says that we're not a terror to good works. We want you to live in peace. It says in verse 3 of Romans chapter 13, for rulers are not a terror to good works, but to the evil. Do that which is good, and thou shalt have praise of the same. There will be no need for us to judge you when you're doing that which is good, right, and godly in God's eyes. But the reason we have to do it is because we're trying to bring you back into right standing with the Lord. And I'll give you this, and I'll leave you all with this, but the Lord is trying to raise up judges and deliverers for you, for your benefit, for your good. But because you choose to be rebellious, the Lord's hand is against you. He's not for you because you're choosing to be stubborn and rebellious and to go a-whoring after other gods. To be a hoe. A whore. Our modern day, we say a hoe. To be a hoe with other gods. You're supposed to be married to God, and you choose to commit adultery on him. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. It says, and we'll just do verse 31 and 32. It says, for if we judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. It means we're spanked of God or whipped by God so that we don't end up being condemned with the world. God doesn't want condemnation. Remember, spanking and whippings are correction. I didn't say beatings. I didn't say abuse. I said spanking and whippings are correction. That's what the Lord does. He wants to correct you. And he tries to do it in love. But then many of you decide, I'm going to be rebellious. I'm going to do my own thing. I don't need God. Oh, I'm fine with God. Yet you know in your heart you're not doing right by the Lord. And so you go off and you commit adultery on God. And you just expect God to accept it. Right? But here's the thing. Even though you commit adultery, the Lord says this. We'll start at Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 12. It says, go and proclaim these words toward the north, and say, return thou backsliding Israel, saith the Lord, and I will not cause mine anger to fall upon you. For I am merciful, saith the Lord, and I will not keep anger forever. Only acknowledge thine iniquity, only acknowledge your hidden sin in your heart. Only acknowledge thine iniquity, that thou hast transgressed against the Lord thy God, and hast scattered thy ways to the stranger under every green tree, and ye have not obeyed my voice, saith the Lord. Turn, O backsliding children, saith the Lord, for I am married unto you. I am what? For I am married unto you, and I will take you one of a city and two of a family, and I will bring you to Zion. That means I'll bring you to a place of peace. I'll bring you to a place of rejoicing. I'll bring you a place of rejoicing. I will bring you to a place of rest. And I will give you pastors according to mine heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. Listen, I had to teach this message because I had to go back in the Rolodex, in the index, in the memory of what the Lord has been telling me to teach you all throughout these weeks. And I have to go back and teach on seasons as well, because the Lord told me that probably a month and a half ago about seasons. And I said, okay, Lord, I'll teach them about seasons. And seasons actually ties into this, because many of you will miss your season because you refuse to listen to the judge and the deliverer. You say it's too hard, it's too harsh, I don't want to hear it. But if it's convicting you like that, and it's cutting up the things that God needs to clear out to make you a vessel of honor, you should want to hear it. And you should ask God for forgiveness. And you should receive his correction and rejoice over it, because at the end of the day, he could have just snatched your breath and you could be in hell right now. Listen, the Lord will raise up a deliverer. The Lord will raise up a judge if you truly want him to. And that deliverer and that judge will not only judge you when you're doing wrong, but he'll show you the love of God when you're doing right, and he'll tell you that God is pleased with what you're doing, because they're connected. They're in tune with God. They can hear his voice clearly. But when you're doing wrong, what does the Bible say? He's not a terror unto good works, but unto the evil. We have to be a judge, a terror to the evil works, because God wants to bring you back to him, a place of peace, a place of rejoicing, a place of rest. Many of you all miss your season because you refuse to obey and to listen to the judge and the deliverer. But God wants you to return, that he can heal your body, that he can bring you to a place of rest, that he can clear out the terrible memories and the bad thoughts from your heart, and that he can show you your iniquity and that you acknowledge it, that he can clean it up for you, and then he can show himself to you in a greater way on a consistent basis. So I love you all. I will see you all again soon. The Lord is not judging you just to judge you. He doesn't send people to judge you just to be evil and harsh to you. He sends people to judge you, to bring you into a place of peace and rest. To bring you into that place of not worrying about what people say, but knowing what God says about you. Not being ashamed or having to follow the crowd of the people around you, as they did in the book of Judges, the children of Israel, to go after their gods and end up in the same condemnation and the same place in eternity that they will end up, which is hell and the lake of fire. The love of God is here. It's shed abroad to you, but you must listen, seek God's face, and obey. Not saying there won't be times where you'll make mistakes, but you won't walk in that mistake continually. You won't walk after those other gods continually. You will do your best to find your way back to the Lord and live holy to the best of your ability. I love you all. I will see you all again soon. The Lord shall raise up a deliverer. May God bless. We are out.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
Accepting the fact that my goal is the top, then knowing heaven is in that spot keeps driving me nonstop. Never allowing hell to defeat me. It's not possible as long as it's beneath me. Nothing sent from there could ever.